afternoon to everyone. It's a pleasure to be with you today. My name is Ander, and I'm going to introduce my team members, who are Roger Roué, Victor López, Aitor Arcona, Marcel Magrané, Enrique Ramírez, and Alex Sancho. What we would like to do today is to talk about lab-grown meat. The purpose of this speaking is to update you on the different ways of making meat.
Excuse me, sorry. Your name again, please?
Ander. Ander Sagasti.
Ander, thank you.
What we would like to do today is to update you on the different ways of making meat instead of killing animals and how this affects to our society. We divided our presentation into about 6 parts. Firstly, we are going to give you an introduction, and then we're going to explain when did it start. A little bit of history of its beginnings. Secondly, we will describe how a burger is made in the 2 different ways, which are cultured meat and plant-based meat. Thirdly, we are going to talk about health terms and how this influence to vegetarians and vegans. After that, we are going to talk about interesting facts and ethical considerations. And finally, a conclusion with the bibliography. Well, by now, you probably heard that eating meat is bad for you. Several studies have found that eating chickens, cows, turkeys, and many other animals increases your risk of cancer. Also, eating meat increases makes it harder to maintain a healthy body weight. It is known that meat eaters are 3 times more likely to be obese than vegetarians and 9 times more likely than vegans. Therefore, if we look to people that might start a diet, probably the first thing they give up eating would be meat. So, did you know that the ex-president of USA Bill Clinton become vegan because he wants to avoid these problems and live longer being a grandfather? Well, he says now that turn to diet vegan is what he likes the best. Another interesting fact is that to make animals grow at a fast rate, the cattle industry feed them with pellets, which are food inspired in the dog food with a lot of hormones, natural and synthetic ones. Meat may seem to be a natural product, but that's not true. When you eat a piece of meat, you are ingesting a lot of hormones to your body. That causes alterations to your body. For example, if we look to women who are pregnant, they need to eat meat because of their vitamins and minerals. But if they do that, they are ingesting hormones to their child that at that moment doesn't need. Or another case is that the acceleration of puberty in the young girls because they ingest progesterone and estrogen, which are the female hormones. Related to this, there are the foodborne illnesses, which can be transmitted by eating meat also. In relation to a study made by Consumers Report, 90% of the raw chicken sold in the United States supermarket is contaminated with bacteria that can make consumers sick. So why I explain all this information? Because all these causes led to a new way of making meat without the necessity of killing animals. Lab-grown meat is a new way to avoid these problems and eat meat healthy. So the question is, would you eat lab-grown meat? And according to a poll, online poll made by ITV, best known as independent television. 50% of people say that they would try it, 44% that they won't taste it, and the 6% remaining that they didn't know. Now it's turned to my partner, Aleix.
Well, first of all, I will start talking about when did it start. At the beginning, we mentioned an appointment that Winston Churchill drew in 1931, that he says that we shall escape the absurdity of growing a whole chicken in order to eat their breast or their wings by growing these parts separately in a suitable medium. This appointment led many researchers to think about the possibility of create a new type of meat, the lab-grown meat. The culturing of stem cells from animals has been possible since 1990s, including the production of small quantities of tissue which could be cooked and eaten. Lab-grown meat starts in 1998 with a patent seeked by John F. Payne of the United States in order to produce tissue engineered meat for the human consumption. After that, the first edible sample was created by a bioscience research company in 2002 which could be growing goldfish cells in order to produce fish fillets. A year later, in 2003, some organizations exhibited in Nantes a stick a few centimeters wide grown by frog stem cells, which was cooked and eaten. Later in 2008, PETA, people from ethical treatment of animals, offered a $1 million prize to the first company who bring a lab-grown chicken meat to the consumers by 2012. As of 2012, 30 laboratories around the world announced that they are doing the research from cultured meat. And finally, in August 5 of 2013, scientists from Maastricht University, led by Mark Post, that you can see in this picture, created the first lab-grown burger in the world. This burger was created by stem cells from a cow. This burger was cooked by Chef Richard McJohn and it for two very famous critics. These critics, when they test the burger, says that it has a nice bit and a flavor similar to the common burger ones. But the only negative aspect they found is that the burger hasn't had fat, and this affects to the choice of this type of meat. After the first public trial, several startups make advances in this field. And for example, Memphis Meat, a startup founded by a cardiologist, published a video in 2016 in which they showcased it cultured beef meatball. Furthermore, in 2017, 2 months ago, they showcased chicken tenders and duck or ranch. That this is the first cultured poultry-based food shown to the public. And if we talk to the present, nowadays several startups are making this process so cheaper. But this is a long time, cause a long time to do this type of reduce of cost. But they claim that in 7-8 years later, this type of meat can be compared with the common meat that nowadays we eat. And this is the end of my part, but later I will explain you some interesting facts.
I'm Gerber, and now we are going to talk about the two different types of lab-grown meat that exist, cultured meat and plant-based meat. I'm going to talk to you about the first one, and later on my teammate Dito is going to explain what plant-based meat is. Cultured meat. Also called synthetic meat or in vitro meat, is a type of meat created by a process called cell culture. This process consists in growing a certain type of animal cells in a controlled environment. To obtain results from this process, it is needed to feed the cell with some substance like amino acids, carbohydrates, oxygen, and others. This way of getting in is very interesting because of four main factors. The first one is that it is a harmless process towards the animals. No animals are killed in the process of extracting the cells, and it is a painless process. Second one is that because it's a very controlled and strict process, it is possible to avoid all kinds of viruses, bacteria, or other type of substance that can produce an illness to a consumer. The third one is that this type of production will be done in vertical farms in the future. So, and this type of farm is done in a very little space. And some studies state that in just 1 hectare of a vertical farm, it is possible to obtain the same results as 10 to 20 hectares from an ordinary farm. And the last one, it is that it is possible to create a huge amount of food from just a few original cells. This amount of food is so enormous that some researchers state that in the best conditions it is possible to obtain 50,000 tons of meat from just 10 original cells of pork in a time lapse of 2 months. It is possible to obtain more meat from these original cells, but in reality the process became a bit complex and the quality of the meat would decrease. But to obtain this huge amount of meat from just a few tiny group of cells is not a cheap process. Luckily, in the last years, the researchers improved a lot this process, and the price of this meat has decreased a lot. To give you numbers, in 2013, the year that the first synthetic burger was made, it would cost you around 250,000 euros to buy just a single synthetic burger. And nowadays, it would cost you around 8 euros. If you compare them, you can feel that it has a lot of potential, but nowadays it is still a bit expensive. One factor that maybe it's against the full development of this type of meat is the general acceptation, because there are some sectors of the society that has unclear opinions and don't accept that type of meat. But these opinions normally are misconceptions, because they think that this synthetic meat has a lot of bad substances and perjudicial toxins, but in reality it is not true. In a synthetic burger, some critics say that it has a very similar taste that and the originals. It's still far away from the conventional one, but it is similar, and also with its appearance and its texture. And also, its nutritional values are even better than the originals, because with this process it is possible to avoid fats, and it is possible to inject some good substance like omega 3. And now my teammate Victor is going to explain like this.
Hi, my name is Victor, and I'm going to talk about plant-based meat. As his name indicates, this type of meat is made from plants. modified with hemoglobin to look, taste, smell, and feel like me. Pat Brown, who invented this technology with other scientists, is also the founder of the Impossible Foods. They both investigate and have restaurants to sell their food. Impossible Foods had a great startup with some important investors like Bill Gates. It was founded in 2011, and they spent 5 years investigating to master the production of the food. This year, they started opening restaurants in the United States. Due to the vegetal origin of the Impossible Burgers, they claim that they use 95% less ground, 74% less water, and 87% less greenhouse effect than a conventional hamburger from cows. They make the Impossible Burger entirely from plants, without the destructive impact of the livestock. These burgers have more proteins, less total fats, and less calories. It also has no cholesterol, antibiotics, or synthetic hormones. Now I'm going to talk about their meat. The fabrication of the burger starts with different types of vegetal proteins, specifically with potato and wheat proteins. They give the burger its characteristic texture and some important nutrients. Then the flavors are added: vitamins and amino acid sugar and hemoglobin. This one is the same that is in your blood, but this one is fermented. They consider it the magic ingredient that makes the burger a carnivorous meal. After this, different types of natural blenders are needed to complete the process. To end the process, they add vegetal fats, in particular coconut oil and soybeans. As you can see, this process is totally made with non-animal products. If you want to see how real they look, you can visit the Impossible Foods website. Finally, as my classmate Enrique will talk about later, this meat is a good solution for vegetarians.
My name is Aitor, and now I will discuss about whether low-grade meat has health benefits or if it is at least healthy. This has been a very controversial topic, but there have been lots of arguments all over these years since low-grade meat started to be developed. But now I'm here to clarify all of these topics. As you already know, one of the most advanced techniques to create low-grade meat consists in taking muscle-specific stem cells from real cows, and then coaxing those cells to create fibers of muscle tissue, and then assembling all of these fibers into a hamburger patty. Mark Post, the creator of the lab-grown meat, states that this kind of meat doesn't have any health concerns. Furthermore, it is healthy. And he's actually true. Since this kind of meat doesn't need any kind of antibiotic because they are produced in contaminated labs and their environment is controlled. Also, since we don't need any kind of real cow to produce hamburger meat, the risk of being infected by some bacterial infections like Salmonella is extremely low. And what's more, it is also possible to adjust the fat to protein ratio and to tweak the nutrition table of the meat. As you can see, here we have the nutrition facts of a lab-grown meat and the nutrition facts of a McDonald's patty. First of all, we can see that the lab-grown meat has a lot more calories than the McDonald's counterpart. However, these calories come as a wall from fat, while in the McDonald's meat, some calories come from healthy chemicals. In comparison with the McDonald's patty, you can see that lab-grown meat has no cholesterol, some more sodium, some potassium, and carbohydrates. and also some proteins, some more proteins. And then here's the big difference. As we can see, the lab-grown meat has a lot more of vitamins and healthy nutrients than McDonald's meat. I can't talk about fat and about fat and saturated fat because these proportions are still being studied to see if they are healthy. In addition, some researches have suggested that for example, omega-3 fatty acids, as Roger said, could be added as a health bonus. Also, here we can see the nutrition facts of plant-based meat. And as you can see, they are more or less similar to the cultured meat. I'd like to add that this kind of hamburger meat, we can see that this kind of hamburger meat is healthier than fast food meat. However, we shouldn't eat it in a regular basis. And this hamburger meat shouldn't replace any other kind of food. Before moving on to the next point, we should not talk about environmental issues. Switching to lab-grown meat could put down on the land and the water used for the production of regular meat. And also, Mark Cox, the creator of the lab-grown meat, states that also this for deforestation and the land used for livestock could be reduced, as well as the methane gas produced by cows. Nevertheless, one big concern about this production of lab-grown meat is the amount of heat and electricity that we need to produce lab-grown meat in a massive scale. Finally, remember that all these statements are predictions. The reality will show in 5 to 10 years.
My name is Enric Ramírez. Enric Ramírez. And as a vegetarian, I think this topic is very interesting because it offers the possibility of eating meat without having to kill animals. If this innovation works, animal exploitation will be healthy reduced. As we saw earlier, there are two different ways to produce this meat. The plant-based one would be more focused on vegans because it wouldn't come from an animal, and the cultured meat would be enough for the vegetarians because of not having to kill any animal while still eating the meat we know nowadays. Currently, a lot of people agree with vegetarians or vegans ideals, but they don't stop eating meat because they would have to renounce a part of their daily menu. They enjoy how it tastes, and its proteins. With the SMID, we wouldn't need to choose between eating or not, or not, and without sacrificing anything. Also, this type of food would be healthier, and it would help to not eat fats and to avoid having illnesses and obesity. However, I think that, in my opinion, not everyone would want to eat this type of meat, because some people find it disgusting to eat something created in such a technological way. Because is that it would not have the reception wanted.
Well, as I said, I will tell you some interesting facts. First of all, I will talk to NASA investigations, because NASA has been doing investigations and experiments in 2001 producing cultured meat from turkey cells. Another interesting fact is that McDonald's said that he would be the first fast food restaurant in the world that have implemented this type of meat on his menu. But also, he said that he wants to produce their own chicken McNuggets in special laboratories around New Jersey to reduce the kill of chicken. And finally, the composition of this meat, as I said, Aitor, doesn't have bones and fat, and this produces a disadvantage to the savory of this type of meat. But also for the kids to want to eat traditional plates, see as buffalo wings, they can do with no problems, because the savory is not so hard. And now I give us with Marcel with the conclusions. And
hi, my name is Marcel Bernanet, and I'm going to talk about the ethical considerations and finally the conclusions. Ethically, there's an obvious upset, which, as my friend said before, many animals won't have to die and live cruel lives. But this also has an important disadvantage, because many people, once the prices drop and people start trusting in this type of meat, will lose their jobs. As important technology advances do, a lot of people will do street protests and will manifest against this type of meat, because robots will take their jobs. But governments should find new solutions to these farms, which will not be good. The main downside is that people nowadays still doesn't trust meat that was produced in labs. As we can see here, they ask some people about the cultured meat, and very few of them have already tried. But the most important thing about the percentage of people is that almost half of them haven't heard of it, and that's because it's a new technology, and more people that have heard of it wouldn't dare trying it. As we said before, this would be hard for people to accept, and it will require at least 10 to 20 years, as we finally see it here nowadays, and maybe replacing the current meat. Even if the main idea of the cultured meat is to make the typical hamburgers, we found a company called Bistro In Vitro, which innovates a bit more of terms of how they serve the meat. They have some dishes that include putting sodium into the meat, so the voltage of the meat changes, and when you are going to eat it, this meat moves. They also make origamis and, for example, ice creams with meat, and even they are trying to produce meat from extinct species, so we could know how they taste. Finally, the conclusions, we think that this type of meat is going to be, this type of food is going to be in a future where food can be easily produced, it is cheap and it is healthy. We also think that it will become a common thing, and in some years we will think that eating meat from animals, it will be a strange thing, and it will also solve problems with long distance traveling like space, because as my friend already said, NASA was researching, and it's an easy way to produce lots of food without many products. Thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed it, and feel free to ask any questions.
They really do deserve that we clap. That was an excellent presentation by the whole group, which doesn't happen very frequently, I have to say. So that was a really good presentation, and you all did very, very well, and I'm very, very pleased with your presentation, so congrats. Okay. Now, here are the questions, some easy questions for you. Now, why do we need lab-grown meat? Don't we have enough meat in the world? Why do we need
it? It's more for replacing the current meat than having another type of meat.
Yeah, but why do you think that we need to replace the kind of meat that we have? Is it so toxic, so contaminated, so polluted that we have to create meat? Anybody?
Well, actually, I think that we are not conscious that cows are causing with gas emissions like methane. I think that if we are not conscious, lab-grown meat is a solution, because it's very contaminated, the gas methane, because cows are, I think that a very good percentage of the gas emissions of methane are cows, and we think that cars and industries are the most likely to be the contamination, but cows are, I think that it's the cows that, but
it also requires less water and less space.
Right.
And also the population of the world is growing in a speedy way this time, and maybe in the future it is difficult to
Food for everybody,
and this is a way to cover it.
Right, I was going to ask you that. Could this be a good solution for the hunger problems that some countries have, particularly in the third world? So
yeah,
could it be the solution?
If it is possible, it's a solution. Problem.
Mm-hmm. Okay, anything you would like to say about the topic? Anything you want to comment on?
If you want to search the strange meat,
If I want to search what, sorry?
The strange laboratory meat.
I want to see the jelly one, the one that moves. I think my can look.
It was bizarre.
Uh-huh.
They also want to make meat from things. Something like Einstein or...
My goodness. Is that for real?
Yes.
In vitro. Bistro in vitro.
Yes.
Wow, we're going nuts, that's for sure. Okay, well, thank you very much. Group number 5 from group B2, I'm really pleased with what you did. Congratulations. Well done.